Hello and welcome to the presentation about OpenMapTiles. My name is Tomas Pohanka. I am working for MapTiler as geodata specialist. And one of my duties is maintaining OpenMapTiles project. What I would like to present to you today is of course about OpenMapTiles project. And we are going to start with a little bit of history. Then we will move to the current state of OpenMapTiles and, of course, what new features and functionalities will be in the next release, and we will talk about ideas for future development. First of all, I would like to introduce OpenMapTiles project. OpenMapTiles is an open source project which allows you to convert OpenStreetMap data or any other spatial data through PostgreSQL database to vector tiles in MPTiles format. All stack is fully dockerized. That means that from importing data to generating vector tiles is running in Docker. What data will be included in vector tiles is easily and fully manageable in SQL files and YAML files. The styling and the vector style is also fully customizable, and entire styling process is done on client side. OpenMapTiles project is here for almost 5 years with continuous active community development and the whole time maintained by MapTiler team. With active community development, there are constant improvement on data side where we keep adding new features or optimizing the current data, and of course, look and feel of the map styling. The main purpose of OpenMapTiles is to provide general purpose map with content without the thematic layers, for example, the ski layers. The project starts with the idea to have whole planet on 64 gigabyte flash drive or micro SD card. These times are gone with the wind, and with additional features and more data in OpenStreetMap, we are now on 1882 gigabyte MPTiles for a whole planet up to zoom level 14. But nevertheless, now the 182 gigabytes micro SD card cost less than 64 gigabyte flash drive back in 2016. Every month, more than 250 million people could see the vector tiles generated by OpenMapTiles project. That is a lot of people and also a huge number of different companies and projects which use OpenMapTiles project for generating vector tiles and displaying them on their projects. In a MapTiler, we are offering vector and raster maps services for OpenMapTiles. We have cloud solution for direct use and downloading with pre-generated packages with weekly updates. You can all find them on maptiler.com. In general, the OpenMapTiles project is composed from two repositories, the OpenMapTiles repository and OpenMapTiles tools repository. OpenMapTiles repository defining the schema. The schema defines which data will be showed in particular zoom level. So, for example, we would like to show on zoom level 1 the names of continents and oceans, but on this level we do not want to show the streets in the cities. On the other hand, for zoom 14, which is the lowest zoom level for now, we would like to show almost all possible features which are available. Through make file targets is called the second project, OpenMapTiles tools, which contains all tools necessary for import data into PostgreSQL and generate vector tiles itself. OpenMapTiles project is multi-platform, and you can generate your own vector tiles with Docker. After downloading OpenMapTiles project from GitHub, there are 7 makefile targets for creating vector tiles. The 7 steps are there for importing data from different sources. The first target is for download OpenStreetMap data, for example from GeoFabric or any other source. Second target is for importing stable data such as nature-earth dataset, which are used for upper zoom level, like 0 to 4, but also for downloading oceans and seas from OpenStreetMap. Next target is importing borders from downloaded OpenStreetMap data. This target is also used for importing data from downloaded OSM data into PostgreSQL database based on mapping YAML files. After import data, there could be a step for import Wikidata. If some features have Wikidata ID, then it is possible to improve data with languages translations from Wikidata, of course. The next target is import all SQL files which preprocessing or modifying OSM data into desired state. And the last target is for generate vector tiles. And at the end, you have a single MP tiles file ready to use on DWeb. Now, something about last release. Last release is version 3.12, which was released with 2 fixing versions, so now it is 3.12.2. But there was 190 merge pull requests done by 30 individual contributors, so it's huge work. That means that there were improved, for example, building aggregation on zoom level 13, also added features for airport maps or fixed protected areas, or add functionality for simple highlighting national borders. There was also improved SQL performance, unified syntax for SQL. Another big improvement was done on continuous integration with GitHub Actions, where every pull request is tested. Also, makefile was greatly improved, and now we are able to work with many different areas in one project. There was also done many enhancements on Windows platform, or Windows platform were enabling downloading from multiple sources. Version 3.12, there was also developed parallel SQL importing and speeding up updates. I have to mention also updates in OpenMapTiles tools, where was made almost 160 commits with many improvements. For example, consolidating all Dockers or using Wikidata Sparkle endpoint. The tool have different releases, so currently release is 5.3.2. Another improvements in tools could be mentioned, such as multi-thread downloading from OSM data or generating documentation for OpenMapTiles tools, also available from make target in makefile in OpenMapTiles. Also, there is MVT debugging tools or automatically pushing new Docker images to Docker Hub. In 160 commits, there are many and many more cleanups and enhancements in tools, and all of them you can see in release notes in the repository. Next release in already in progress, and this version should be 3.13. where we are already made a great improvements for data. For example, added new features for motorway junctions or add a toll tag for highways. Added new mountains features or blocksmith shops, and many other new points. Of course, there are other improvements, such as highway concurrency, where one highway could have many, many marks or many, many segments, which, and although there was improved in fixed road segments, disconnections, or implementation of shipway labels. In version 3.13, there are already implemented integrity checks for importing OSM updates, and this is another great change, that importing borders are now or will be imported directly from InPOSM. But let's look at the most active contributors in the last year. I would like to thank you all for your contribution and the improvements. And any even the issue, if you add an issue into the GitHub, it's improving the whole OpenMapTiles project. In future release version 4 are discussed new possible functionalities which could be added into the release. One discussed area is to add extra zoom, which could add more layers and features. Of course, there will be a great improvement in geometry precision, for example, for buildings. There are also ongoing discussion how to handle custom or add-on layers for used with OpenMapTiles schema. This discussion and implementations suggestions are in drafted pull request number 1003. Could be also nice to have style representing all the layers directly in the repository. And of course, some enhancement which in current version will cause breaks in already using map styles. So these changes are waiting for future release, but it will lead to smaller tiles. If you would like to start with OpenMapTiles, look at our workshop that we had here on FOSS4G on Monday. It is also on our MapTiler YouTube channel. This presentation will be published on YouTube too. At the end, I would like to summarize this presentation. OpenMapTiles is an open source community project developed by companies and map enthusiasts. The latest stable release is 3.12, and we are working on 3.13. If you have any ideas for future release, version 4, please write an issue on GitHub. Look at our YouTube channel or openmaptiles.org for more information about OpenMapTiles. And thank you for your attention. And if you have any questions, I will be glad to answer them. I'm sorry that my presentation was a little short, but I think it's Friday and I hope it's okay. Sorry, you are on mute.
Yes, thank you. And thank you for your amazing presentation. It was really clear and you provide a lot of other documents and pointers to the documentation. It was really nice. We have some questions from the audience and we have time to discuss this.
Of course.
One of the first questions is, in your detailed workflow with all the steps to create a server, is it possible to reproject the data to a national SRID, for example?
In this moment, the MapTiles specification allows to store only web Mercator projection. So, and it's most common, representing the web maps. But yeah, so basically no. But in MapTiler Cloud, we have these custom coordinates. But in specification, is just for web Mercator.
Yeah, it's in some way like JSON or GeoJSON that only supports the WGS 84, but people like to have it in other national or local or coordinating systems. But the specification is clear in the sense that they only support one SRS. Another question is are the schema changes documented?
The schema changes are documented in release notes. So there are all the commits and the documentation of each commit will be in a release note. So for version 3.13, there are no breaking change. So we just adding new features, for example, or new tags. So there are no breaking change. It's planned for or discuss what change we will make in version 4. And it's in feature and still in discussion. Yes, of course, the import OSM step is looking for PBF file. So if you have any your own extract, you can download or use this OSM data. Or, of course, if you import some your custom open data into the PostgreSQL, you can create a custom layer for this table or layer in PostgreSQL, and you can generate your own files with your own data. And I would like to point to our workshop from Monday, where we did exactly this, that we import the Buenos Aires bike stations or bike shops and generate new layer from open data. Yes, you can use your own data, open data, or your company data, and import them into the PostgreSQL database. And if they are in PostgreSQL database, you can write a configuration file and SQL file, which are and create new layer. So you can. Yes, you can use your own data, it's no problem. And in the step make import SQL, we'll import the SQL function. And as I mentioned, please look on our GitHub. It's github.com/MapTiler/FOSS4G minus workshop, where these steps are right by step-by-step manual. Yes, and thank you for